this video is to discuss the Promethean ActivInspire Browsers. The Browsers panel is located on the left-hand side of your screen, right over here. If the panel does not show up, to get it to open, you go to View, Browsers, or Control B is the toggle to toggle it off and back on. You can actually move the browser. If you click on the toolbox button at the top, you can actually drag it and move it to unlock it from over there on the left. You can also click on this to dock it to the right. You can also have it floating around the screen as well. If you wanted to close your browser, the X right here will allow you to close it. Again, to get it back open, View, Browsers. You can pin your browser just like you pin your toolbox. Right here to the right is a pin icon. If the push pin is orange, it means that it is on, and the browser's panel is going to stay up on your screen all the time. If you click on that to toggle it off, now your browser will hide until you come and move over near it, and then it will show up on your screen. You can also resize your browser panel by clicking your mouse off to the edge, either the left or the right edge, depending on where your browser is locked. And if you press and hold the mouse key and start dragging to the right or to the left, it'll allow you to resize that panel. In the browsers, there are a number of different browsers. The first one is the page browser. This allows you to add, delete, duplicate, or move slides within your presentation. You just can click and drag them to move them around, right click to copy or to duplicate or paste. This is similar to the view of PowerPoint's slide viewer when you're in PowerPoint making a presentation. The second browser is the resource browser. This allows you to look for multimedia, including pictures, movies, sounds, etc., to use in your flip chart. The shared resources, the one with the people on them, are the resources that have come from Promethean. You can also add your own resources to the browser by dragging them and dropping them into the panel down here at the bottom. You just select your folder and then you just drag the option, the picture or whatever, into the browser, and now it's always in your resource browser, so you don't have to go and hunt for it to find it. The third browser is the object browser. This allows you to sort objects in layers, restack items within different layers. You can lock items and hide items from the browser panel. The layers can also be named from this panel, and in a future video there is all about layers. We're going to show you how to rename, move, and lock items. The fourth browser is the notes browser. This is a place to keep notes for yourself or others if you share the flip charts. If you see a yellow sticky note next to your mode button over here, then that indicates that there is notes attached to this page. And if you click on that little sticky note icon, it will automatically open up the notes browser. The fifth browser is the property browser. This allows you to change the appearance of your flip chart page and or objects on that page. The next browser is the action browser, which allows you to assign actions to any given object. It also includes drag and drop actions that you can click on and drag them, and the action is automatically applied. So these are quick and easy actions that you can put on any flipchart page that you're working on. And the last browser is the voting browser, which allows you to register devices to allow students to vote. So you can also view reports from questions and change settings from this panel. And voting and question creation will be discussed in depth in a future video. So let's look at a page so that you can see what these different browsers look like on an actual page. So here's the first one. The page browser looks the same. Second one, the resource browser. I don't have any resources open, but I could open some of my folders. You can see some of the resources that are there, and again, to attach them, you just drag them and drop them. Now I just added a grid to this page. The third one is the object browser. Again, you can see that there are some objects that are hidden. I have things locked. I have a lot of different items on different layers. The fourth is the notes browser, and again, up here at the top, you've got your sticky note. So if I click on that, it will automatically open up the notes browser, which gives me the information about this slide, what to do, correct answer choices, etc. Nothing really different in the properties browser. Actions, some items have actions attached, like this button, for example. So I can click on that and it'll actually show me what action is attached, a hidden action in the target, and that you can go in depth and watch the actions video for that. And if I had clickers currently attached, I could engage this and it would send it to the clicker since it's a question sheet. So this video was the ActivInspire Browsers and their descriptions.